Hey guys, how's it going? This is Steve with All Dogs Off-Road, and on today's video, I'm gonna run through how to prepare a Bilstein 5100 for assembly onto your vehicle. Now, this is gonna be specifically applicable to the Nissan Frontier Nextera, but you can also, you know, gain a lot of information about your own vehicle because all this stuff is pretty similar, but these top hats are specific to the Frontier Nextera, so that's why I stated it's gonna be specific. So let's get started. Opening up the box of your Bilstein 5100, you're gonna have a couple things. We'll move these out of the way here. You're gonna have a couple things that come in the box. First and foremost, it's gonna be this bag of hardware. You're gonna take this, we'll put it aside super quick. And then next is gonna be instructions and your shock and shock boot. Now, the first thing is this plastic piece here could come off. You're not going to need this. So, you have your shock, you have your shock boot, and you have your bag of hardware. So, in order to prep this shock for assembly onto your vehicle, you're going to do the following. First thing that you're going to do is you're going to take this spring perch, and you're going to put it onto your shock. Now, one thing that we see all the time is people will take their shock and they will put the spring perch on like this and then put their spring on. Do not do this. This is not how your shock is supposed to be set up. You want to make sure that when you do this, that your spring perch is installed the correct way, which is facing down like this. So, once you know how to properly do that, you can pay attention to these grooves here on the shock itself. If you're using your factory coil spring, you can use this adjuster to adjust from 0 inches of lift all the way up to 2 inches of lift. If you're using a lift spring in conjunction with this Bilstein 5100, such as an Old Man Emu coil, a Dobson's coil, or an All Dogs Off-Road coil, you're gonna wanna leave your circlip on the bottom setting to allow the spring to do all the lifting. So we're gonna put our spring perch on, seat it, and then the next step is gonna be the shock boot. Now, there's a lot of heated debate on the internet about whether or not you wanna use a shock boot on your shock. Bilstein includes it. Usually, you know, you can't go wrong putting a shock boot on in most cases. In performance applications, they generally recommend no shock boot because oftentimes it'll hold in more grime than it will protect against. But for sake of, you know, your warranty and for sake of explaining how this works, we're just going to run with the shock boot on. And then the next thing that you're going to do is you're going to run this zip tie around the neck of the shock boot and zip that all the way down. I am actually not going to do that because we're going to probably use this Bilstein later down the road. But if you choose to not use your shock boot, one thing to remember is you want to make sure that this metal spacer here is removed from the shock boot, because if you choose to not use the shock boot, you still need to use this metal spacer when you're doing your assembly. So, shock boot on, your spacer is on as well, and the next thing that you're gonna do is you're gonna reach into your bag and you're gonna grab your washer. Now, you're gonna get this washer and you're gonna mount it facing up, just like that. And then at that point, all you have left in your bag is just gonna be this top nut. So we're gonna put a pause on this. Right now, we're about as far as we can get with this shock alone. So we're gonna set this aside and we're gonna pay attention to our top mount hardware now. All right, now that we have a fully prepped Bilstein 5100, we can pay attention now to the top hat hardware. So once you have your boot spacer and your washer on correctly, you're gonna grab your top hat and it's gonna go on top. Now at this point, we're assuming that you have already, you know, put your Bilstein through the spring and you're just assembling the top part now. So isolator goes on, top hat goes on. The next part is gonna be this sleeve right here is gonna slide onto your rod end and push down just like that. Easy peasy. Next, you're gonna get your bushing, throw it on top, washer, aim it down onto your ice, onto your bushing, and then grab your top nut and crank it down. So one thing that can happen when you're tightening this down is that you're gonna be rotating it, but the shaft is just gonna be free spinning inside the shock body, so you're not gonna be able to actually tighten this. If you notice, I'll take this off so you can see better. The top of this shaft is notched so that you can grab it with a set of pliers or a box wrench so that you can hold on to it while you tighten down your top nut and you'll be good to go. So guys, hope you learned something. This is how to properly prepare your Bilstein 5100 for assembly onto your vehicle. This is Steve with All Dogs Off-Road. Thanks for watching.